my next coup combination on spotting. It's very easy because I just max the spotting range on my DD. Let's do look how it worked into the game. First, we were talking about the coup. I used the Kaspar Mask as a captain because he has Battle Instinct. It's 6 tanks, like 6 tanks in tanks. It worked the same way. He give you 6 tanks. Giant Killer, if you kill the battleship or aircraft by torpedoes or by guns, you get the better reload on your torpedoes. Stack it, then you have more kills, faster reloads. Enchanted Scout. Enchanted Radar 2, 150 meters. I use it on 3 stars. It doesn't matter how many stars he has. If you promote him on 4-5 stars, I will show you he changed the spotting. Where is it? Where is he? Kasper, there is Kasper. Relief. He get Enchanted Radar 3 and he get next 50 meters. The second one I used the Reinhardt von Maslow. He give you 1 knot and 200 meter spotting range, and he have very good effectivity to use on gunner. You must promote him on 4 stars to get the Enchanted Radar 3. But it's not hard if you play well, if you play fleet battles, and if you are part of the fleet who winning the games. The third one is Felix von Lackner. He give you 7% disguise on 3 stars, 150 meters scouting range, and 5% of acceleration. If you promote him on 4 stars, you will get the next skill, it's State of War, perfect and for movies, every perfect for when life. You lit up the enemy ship, it's Discovery, or just spot him, you have chance to get, or you just get the 10% of reload. Every time when you spot some enemy ship, it's very good if you fight against enemy DD, you get the faster reload than him. The position of a communication specialist is a little bit difficult. There you can have three sailors. You can have there Nakayama Arashi. It's a spotter what you get on five tier DD. He give you 500 meters. If you assign him like a common specialist, he have survival instinct and torpedo speed. It's I doesn't use him because he has 3 stars and I have the second one who give you the 500 spotting bench, spotting range on common specialist. The next one in Andrew Cunningham, it's my favorite because he give you 500 spotting range, sonar detection and communication range 400 meters. It's good to use on DD because if you need to spot and spot the SS, he give you advantage because he give you sonar detection and scouting range. Or you can use just Kimura Kazuo. He give you the 500 spotting range on common specialist and cunning. Cunning is very useful skill on every ship. It says you have 55 chance decrease disc use lost by 15% when you firing with artillery at least 30 seconds. It's very very useful, and you can use it on battleship. Battleship or heavy cruiser or DD, you can use everywhere, and it's very universal sailor. Now I rolled it out 4 days ago. Now I mixed him. You can look on my yesterday video where I take him on level 5 and I'm expecting him on Pensacola. Okay, it's about crew. The communication specialist and the last one is Arturo Riccardi, who if you promote him on 3 starts, he give you next 150 meters. The modules what I use, rangefinder, custom hoist and hydraulic steering gear. It's for maneuverability of your DD, your reload speed and 400 spotting range. The base scouting range of ship of your ship, it depends on this common specialist place. I just get 4% of spotting range because Kazuo is low level. If I will change it, you will see how change numbers. I have something 4840, and if I change, change the bad place. Change the common specialist. If I use Cunningham, I have about 150 meters more because the Cunningham is on level 10. It still you give you advantage against enemy. Then use Arashi because Arashi have lower effectivity than 4-star commanders. Okay, net. Now we will go into the battle and I will show you how spotting work. No, it will be fast. It's nice. I stay against 2 SS and 1 DD. It's fight 8 versus fight 8. And we have advantage with the BB tier 6 and they have Northampton, it's a heavy cruiser, American heavy cruiser tier 6. And they have one SS of tier 6 more than us, but SS is not so big problem. Let's start fight. I hope that my team is not will be so stupid and they will follow me and they will shoot on what I spot. One BB is AFK, second BB is AFK. And there is third BB is AFK, cool. 75% of our BB stay. So cool, so stupid. So unfair. Okay, now we will see what we spot. I think that I have the advantage against... I have some luck. I spot the DD on 4 kilometers, SS on 3.6 kilometers. I will use Kaspar to know where I am spotted. And with the Kazuo, he doesn't see me and I can shoot. Oh, nice. Our BB standing here. If he is go underwater, he will use smoke to get the closer to him. There DD rushing. I hope the our one Pennsylvania can kill him. And we will try to talk the German SS. I use salvo hit and he's dead. He can't avoid the salvo on this close range, and he don't have time to go to critical dive to avoid the torps. It's very easy if you use the smoke tactics. The SS doesn't know about you, and you just go into the smoke and torp him, and he can't see you because he is not in the smoke. Now I hope our battleship killed the enemy battleship. Now we can take some tea or breakfast because we just waiting. Then our team killed the enemy team. It's easy if you have comrades in your party, some fleet mates. They know what they must to do, and they follow you and just killing what you spot. Now you see how enemy battleship running and our battleship shooting on day, and they can do nothing because they don't see. They see nothing, and my team just shooting. But they see because they don't kill the porter. Oh, it's not good. But porter is running there. They try to kill SS. Then we will try to kill the enemy porter. We have closed him. Our VVs are not stupid. It's nice to see because someone shooting on porter, because you know the enemy DD is the most dangerous ship in the game, because if you don't kill the spotter, it's much harder to win. We will use torp ball to hit the enemy ships. Maybe we hit, maybe not, or just they will start must start moving. We will see what they do. I will use again Kaspar Mas because I won't know if something spot me, and we will see if the Orc BB start kill the enemy ships. Maybe we hit two torps to Pennsylvania, but it will be luck because he start moving, but not so fast. He get two torps. Oh no, they explode about 1 meters again, closer to 1 meters yearly, but he get only splash damage. It's about 900. Now I will go the depression day. I will go into the base, and they will start to try to found me in the cap and last our PV who didn't die. Follow me, it's Nevada. You can't shoot on day. I don't know why they stay on cap. It's so stupid tactic. It's losing the game. Try to kill the porter now. One hit. We have enemy SS on our base. Doesn't turning, why? Northampton is trying to rush me. I will try to kill him. Him. He's dead. Oh, changing the way. Not easy to hit him on 6 kilometers. And you. I just need to go. Oh, boom, baby, boom! Nice, nice hit. Now he's. I think he's dead now. Yes. They just have Nevada, even our BB killed the Nevada, I will go kill the SS. Or just I will go kill SS now. Use torps to kill our Pensacola, but I think that he torp not good. Destroy the enemy SS. We try to escape, but we can't. I hope that my video will help you with the spotting and with the set the crew on DD. It's not too hard to know that you just what you need is spotting. It's everything, and it's winning the game. On DD, Renown calculated about these numbers. You must make the assist damage is the spotting, and if you have the spotting, you will get the Renown. If you have just damage, your own damage, you doesn't get it. You just get about 8 or 12 spotting Renown or 10. You just get just the lower number. Okay, let's see what I do. I spot. I have assist damage to all members of team, and I have SS and Porter. I kill alone without assist damage and. 3 kills, touch and go, and War Hero MVP. The biggest damage in the team on Destroyer. It's not, not I doesn't like to see it, but it's because I kill 2 SS. Okay, I hope you enjoy my raid and see you next time, guys.